Authentication. So the purpose of authentication. Alice wants to be sure she received data from Bob and not from somebody else. And Bob wants to be sure he received the data from Alice and not from somebody else. So this is basically symmetrical. They want to ensure who is talking to who. Agenda for this part. First, we see that authentication could be addressed with symmetric cryptography and asymmetric cryptography again. Then we'll talk about the risk of impersonation. And to finish, we see how certificate authority could, I would say, mitigate this risk of impersonation. Authentication could rely on two mechanisms: symmetric encryption, asymmetric encryption. Principle will be always the same. Alice will choose a random value, and we can call this challenge, and we'll share it with Bob. Bob will return the encryption of this challenge, and then Alice could check the result to ensure about Bob and identity. With the hash mark, so here we've got Bob and Alice. We are in a symmetric cryptography, so they have a common shared secret, this golden key. Alice will choose a random value, the challenge, and send it to Bob. Bob will concatenate his golden key value with a random one, and then we'll put this in a hash function. So we will have a digest, and we'll send the digest to Alice. Alice symmetrically will take the random value. We'll concatenate with the golden key, put it in the hash function, and get a digest. Then she can compare the digest value. If they are the same, she is sure she received data from somebody who has the common shared secret. So it's only Bob. He don't have this secret, and nobody should have it. So she's sure it's Bob. Another way to do it could be with the RS, and here we will do some encryption. So Alice again, choose a random value, the challenge, send it to Bob. Bob this time will encrypt with a golden key this random value and will return this value encrypted. So Alice could decrypt it and compare the value. It's the same. That means she's talking to somebody who has the same common secret. Always the same mechanism, quite simple. Now let's see with the asymmetric one. In the asymmetric context, now Bob and Alice got key pairs, a public key and a private key. So Alice, for the authentication, choose a random value, the challenge, and share it with Bob. Bob will apply the signature process with his private key. You remember the signature process? For the RSA, just a hash, then an encryption of this hash. Then Bob will send this signature to Alice. Alice will check it. For that, she needs what? The public key of Bob. Okay? It was with the public key, you can decrypt the signatures, get a hash, and check the hash of the random value. This is a signature check. If the signature is okay, that means she's talking to Bob, because she's talking to somebody who has the capability to generate signatures, so the private key. Now I would like to tell you about the risk of impersonation. Here you've got the basic scheme of authentication asymmetrical. You've got some public keys that are published, the Alice one, Bob's one, and they've got their own private key. But what happens if Eve distribute a public key like the Bob's one? It could be simple on internet. Just say, okay, this is the Bob's public key. Take this one and you can do the authentication now. If I take the schematics we've just seen before, here everything's working well. Signature is okay and Alice thinks she's talking to Bob. So the question is how Alice could be sure that Bob's public key is not Eve's public key or somebody else. This is a problem of impersonation. So how can we trust the Bob's public key? And in fact, the answer will be with certificate and certificate authority. This is the last part we will see together. Certificate and certificate authority. First, let's define what is a certificate. Certificate is a digital data that included issue your identification, certificate identification, a public key, and the signatures of all the previous data. So if you well remember what we see before, to generate the signatures, we need a private key. So I would say someone is the owner of this. The one who is the owner of this is the certificate authority. The certificate authority is in charge to generate the certificate. Generate the certificate, it generates the signatures that is embedded inside the certificate. So now Bob won't distribute only its public key, but its certificate. We will see just after how we can check the signatures of the certificate and ensure that the public key is a good one. Now I just give you the most known certificate format, X509DER, just to let you know. And it's saying the certificate and certificate authority that we are able to exchange public key in a trusted way. So let's see the different step for this. Okay, the first step will be that Bob will require a certificate to the CA. To do that, he needs to communicate in a secure way with the CA. He will provide his public key, and the CA will put all the information together and generate the signatures, thanks a private key. Now you well know this. Signature plus source data, it's a Bob certificate. So now Bob won't provide anymore only his public key, but his certificate. Inside his certificate, there is a public key again and a signature of it. And Alice or anybody could check the signatures that is inside this certificate, thanks to the public key of the CA. You could tell me, but Eve replaced the CA public key. It will work and impersonation is here. In fact, CA is an independent certificate authority. I would say it's a well-known one. It's known by anybody, so you can't substitute key or certificate. So at a moment or another, you have to trust somebody. You have to have a starting point when you say, okay, this one, I'm sure this key is valid, without doing some check. It's something you have to rely on it. Now, how Alice will check the Bob certificate? As you can see in the picture, we've got the CA. And the public key of the CA is distributed as a certificate also. In the public domain, we don't have anymore just a simple key, but always a certificate. So we could imagine that we can also check the CA certificate with another CA certificate and a chain of certificate. But to simplify here, I just want to have one level. So Alice will take the Bob certificate. She's got a signature value, so she wants to check the signatures. To do that, she will need the public key of the CA, which is embedded in the CA certificate. She can check the signatures. If the signature is okay, she can use a Bob public key and is sure that it's a Bob public key. Let's have a full picture of the basic authentication with the CA. Alice sends a challenge to Bob. Bob, do a signature of this random value thanks its private key. Then he sends back the signature to Alice. Alice first will check the Bob certificate. So for that, she needs a CA certificate, which allows her to check the signatures inside the Bob certificate. If the signature is correct, that means the public key of Bob that is inside the certificate is a good one. So now she can use it to check the signatures of the challenge. It works. That means the challenge was okay. So Alice now is sure to talk with Bob. Now we finish with authentication. If I sum up, authentication is done thanks to challenge and you can use some symmetric or asymmetric cryptography. If you are using asymmetric cryptography, there is a risk of impersonation. And to mitigate this, you can use a certificate mechanism and a certificate authority which delivers certificate. If the both sides authenticate each other, we are talking about mutual authentication. I give you this wording because it's commonly used.